Hello. So hypothetical questions look like this. What would you do if you had a different opinion from your boss about how to handle something? What would you do if you had to introduce a new policy that you knew wasn't going to be appreciated by your team? What would you do? These questions aren't too different from the competency questions, but instead of asking you to reflect on past experiences, they're asking you to imagine. The problem with imagination is that you can very easily totally go off topic. So, last question of the day. What would you do if, hypothetically speaking, you had a different opinion from your boss about how to do something? Well, I guess I would think about the way that I think that we should do that particular thing. I'd really think about it, and I'd probably start brainstorming around different ways to do it, and I'd probably do that thing where, you know, you put post-it notes on a wall or something just to help visualize your ideas. I think we were told that it's a really good way to just bring your ideas to life and to have, you know, like lateral thinking and thinking outside the box. It really take it to where it needs to go. Yeah, so that's probably how I would do it. Just really approach it, you know, creatively, from a creative angle, and just really thinking outside the box. Thank you very much. With these questions, we're in the hypothetical, so it's very easy to get carried away because you're thinking on your feet. Here are a few tips to make sure that doesn't happen. When preparing for the interview, consider the qualities that the interviewer might be looking for. So often, conflict management, time management, and people skills are up there. Then come up with a list of 6 or 7 different hypothetical situations that hit these qualities on the head. You come into your interview prepared with this list of 6 or 7 hypothetical situations that talk about these qualities that your interviewer is looking for, and you can then adapt them to whatever hypothetical situation you're asked to respond to. Does that make sense? And there you have it. We cover these kinds of questions in a lot more depth in our English Online business English themed classes. So if you're interested to find out more about work themed English, English for the workplace, business English, just click on the link that's in the description and it will take you through to the English Online website. What are some of the best and worst interview answers that you've ever heard? I'd be really interested to know. If you have some gems, then write them in the comments and I will enjoy reading them over a cup of freshly brewed tea. Bye!